This video is a two-parter. You are currently watching part two. Part one is linked in the description and it explains the concept and mechanics of this video. But basically, I'm going to present you with Red Velvet eras and match them with iconic rock songs to create my own Red Velvet rock comeback. I then create a fantasy album including B-sides, themes, and tone notes. Now that that is that, let's get to what you came here for. Bad Boy. Bad Boy gets two edits. Good for you, Bad Boy. I couldn't pick which one I liked more, so this fantasy album has two lead singles. I waited well over a year for this song to enter public use again. I was so patient in order to make this video. Obviously, that was The Chain by Fleetwood Mac. I really love this edit. I think it's sexy, it's dangerous, it's heartstrong, so it kind of feels similar to Bad Boy. I also really like the pacing in this edit. It kind of wraps you into the music. It gets more intense as you hit the finale. The cuts get stronger, kind of highlighting the vocal layering in The Chain, the sound of her voice. Musically, The Chain was assembled by cutting the tapes with like actual razor blades because that's just how things were in the 70s. So that's the first one. Here is the second one, which some of you may recognize. Okay, so this is a totally different kind of sexy. That was, of course, Burnin' For You by Blue Oyster Cult. I stand by the statement that Burnin' For You is one of the greatest songs ever in music, ever. It's incredible, the relationship between the rhythm guitar and the bass and the vocals. Burnin' For You has two basic veins of guitar in it, hot on top and cold on the bottom, and the edit alternates back and forth on which line of sound it's focused on. I think you could argue that out of all the Red Velvet eras, this is the one with the highest amount of pulp rock influence, neon lights, mannequins, references to 80s framing, pulp fashion. American rock in particular has this relationship with the highway, since that's where the American mythos is, and both of these edits feed on that. Bad Boy isn't aggressive like Monster, but it's still very dangerous and seductive. Slow burns were a huge part of rock music during the 70s and early 80s. A lot like The Chain and Burnin' For You, Bad Boy gains power from what's implied. This fantasy album has a lot of charred heat and secrecy. Head Over Heels by Tears For Fears, which is really sensitive and terrified, followed up by Bat Out Of Hell by Meat Loaf, which is really aggressive and spiritual. tone notes for this edit are witchy, scorched, frenetic, and frisky. I still love the way Ice Cream Cake fits with Pour Some Sugar on Me. I think the gas station sugar high kind of feeling makes them fit together with the crazy blonde hair and the choreography and the way everything feels way overexposed and isolated. I think Ice Cream Cake gives off that kind of arena rock feeling. There's just so much to look at. They're putting on such a big show. There are almost these hair rock or glam aesthetics in the video. The biggest change between last year and this year is the inclusion of Irene's center in the chorus. Originally, only Seulgi had the chorus center, and so only the first three parts of the chorus had choreography. Now that Irene goes first, all of Seulgi's parts bump back by one, and now I can have all four parts filled, and even end that line, "I can't get enough," with Seulgi touching her lip. For the B-sides, I want the pulpiest, gas station-iest songs you can get. One Way or Another by Blondie for that sarcastic guitar, Fat Bottom Girls by Queen, and Money Money, a song about a woman so good you had to say her name twice. To see the other edits and fantasy albums, be sure to check out part 1. Thank you for watching.